This is ABC 7 News at Noon. Your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Good afternoon. I'm Don Brennan in for Scott Dennis today. Thank you for joining us. And our top news at noon is day two of the Republican National Convention in Cleveland. Today's focus will be on jobs and the economy. Donald Trump took to the stage on the first night, which is almost unheard of, making a larger-than-life entrance and introducing his wife, Melania. ABC's Stephanie Ramos joins us now with the latest details from Cleveland.
The Trump team has been forced to respond to the Melania speech accusations after what seemed to be, for many here at the convention, a successful first night. Donald Trump stepped out on stage in WWE style.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you. We love you. Thank you very much.
Showing up to his convention on the very first night and briefly speaking to the convention crowd before introducing his wife.
The next First Lady of the United States. Melania Trump.
In her first major speech since the Trump campaign took off, Melania electrified the room.
It would not be a Trump contest without excitement and drama.
The drama following her today. Melania's speech sparking controversy overnight with allegations of plagiarism. Some portions of the speech sounding nearly identical to First Lady Michelle Obama's 2008 convention speech.
You work hard for what you want in life.
That you work hard for what you want in life.
That your word is your bond, that you do what you say you're gonna do.
That your word is your bond, and you do what you say and keep your promise.
Trump's campaign manager, Paul Manafort, vigorously denying the accusations.
To say that she lifted any words from anybody is absurd, and I thought that she effectively explained that parts of Donald Trump's personality that American people have not seen on the campaign trail.
Leading up to the speech, Melania said she wrote it with as little help as possible.
Taking the stage tonight, New Jersey Governor Chris Christie, Ben Carson, House Speaker Paul Ryan, and Trump's kids, Tiffany and Donald Trump Jr. Stephanie Ramos, ABC News, Cleveland.
Thank you, Stephanie. And here at ABC 7, we're continuing our special coverage of the convention as ABC 7's Alan Cohn is in Cleveland as well. He caught up with the chairman of the Republican Party of Sarasota and state representative candidate Joe Gruters to talk about what happened yesterday and expectations for today.
Florida Republicans just had their day two breakfast when they were talking about the events of yesterday. And joining us is Donald Trump's Florida chairman, Joe Gruters. Joe, what a day. From a little bit of a revolt from the Never Trump movement to now a controversy with Melania Trump. Your thoughts?
Well, really, it's just a couple of words out of the whole speech. Melania Trump did an amazing job. She's going to be an amazing first lady. She's beautiful. She's classy. I thought she hit it out of the park last night. And I think that this, what they're trying to do to her and try to compare these speeches, a couple of words out of, 20 minutes is, I think it's really bogus.
What are you hoping out of today?
Well, I think that the theme today is making America work again. So what I'm expecting today is you're going to see a lot more business leaders talk. You're going to see Donald Trump put out his agenda. It's going to be the status quo of D.C., where really everybody believes that the system is rigged out of D.C. Donald Trump is going up there to change it. He's going to put Americans first. He's going to be the champion of middle America.
And we'll have to leave it there. Thanks, Joe. I appreciate it. And we will have updates all day long on the air and online. I'm Alan Cohn at the Republican National Convention in Cleveland. Back to you.
Thank you, Alan. The Democratic convention is next week, and Hillary Clinton is squeezing a stop into Florida prior to heading to Philadelphia. According to the Clinton campaign, the Democratic presidential nominee will be stopping in Orlando and Tampa on Friday, where she'll be holding a rally at the Florida State Fairgrounds. On Saturday, she'll travel to South Florida. No details yet on that trek to South Florida. Afterwards, she'll head to the national convention in Pennsylvania. Of course, ABC 7 will be in Philadelphia next week covering that. Haley Wilgus and Adam Cellini will join Alan and have the latest developments throughout the week. All right, John, well, like you said, a lot of hot air all over the country right now, and a lot of hot air in Florida for sure.
Oh, indeed. Yeah, yesterday we were a degree away from tying a record in the state of Florida for this state, for Sarasota. And today we're going to be warm again, up around the mid-90s. The good news is that, like yesterday, we had a few scattered showers around that rapidly moved across the area. Today, same thing. We've got them already beginning to enter into the viewing area, and I think we'll have some scattered showers around this afternoon. Let's go to what the tower cam this morning showed, which was a beautiful sight on KCK. Watch as the moon sets and the sun rises, And the blue sky turns a little cloudy as the hard east wind blows those clouds in from the east to the west. Now you can see those showers beginning to encroach on the Sun Coast. Some of them producing some pretty good rainfall, but the thing is they move so quickly the total rainfall amounts are not going to be that significant or impressive today, I don't think. Not much of a sea breeze building, so daytime highs are definitely going to be on the warm side. We'll go with about 95 for a daytime high, 50% chance of rain showers, ending kind of early though. I think as we head toward dusk and sunset, we'll start to see the showers begin to fade away, moving out into Gulf waters, and so should be a very pleasant evening. We'll have the complete forecast for you coming up in a few, Don.
Thank you, John. Several car burglaries are being reported throughout Sarasota. The Sarasota County Sheriff's Office says several burglaries took place over the weekend near homes around Fruitville and Cattleman Road. On Sunday night, at least two cars had windows smashed and items taken from the parking lot at Benderson Park. Deputies arrested one person who is accused of breaking into at least one of the vehicles, and people we spoke to were shocked about what happened, and it teaches them a very valuable lesson.
Place like this where it's wide open, you just think people wouldn't have the gumption to do such a thing.
I usually don't even carry my wallet and leave it in the car anymore.
The recent burglaries have prompted the Sarasota Police Department to put up signs reminding you to take your keys and lock your cars. Officers say some of the burglaries are related and some are not, but it's ongoing and the problem we deal with every day. There are also car burglaries in Manatee County as deputies are investigating several of them at a business in Bradenton. It happened between 6 and 6:30 last night in the 3200 block of 59th Drive East. According to the Manatee County Sheriff's Office, unknown suspects smashed the windows of three cars that were parked at that business. Purses and wallets were reportedly stolen. The suspects then fled the area. And soon there won't be any place to get your Brooks Brothers suit, at least in downtown Sarasota, that is. The Brooks Brothers is permanently closing its downtown store on Main Street this weekend. Ahead of the closing, the store is having a huge clearance sale. Huge! Anything that is left over will be moved to the store at the mall at UTC. The downtown location will be closing this Saturday. The upscale clothing retailer has another outlet store at Ellenton Premium Outlets in outside of Palmetto. Now, time to head over to the kitchen where Chef Pedro joins us from the Table Creekside restaurant in Sarasota. Pedro, what's happening for lunch today?
Well, we're going to have a fantastic seafood risotto today, sir, with the Florida lobster.
Local coverage of the Republican National Convention on ABC 7 News is brought to you by Stolarski Orthopedic and Age Vital Compounding Pharmacy.
Need new windows? Buy direct from the factory. New South Window is having a sale. The more you buy, the more you save. Buy four windows, save 25%. Buy six windows, save 30%. Buy eight or more windows and save 35%. How? Because New South owns the factory and you cut out the middleman. Award-winning, energy-efficient windows and doors installed with a lifetime warranty. New South Windows are made in Florida for Florida homes by Florida workers. Visit NewSouthWindow.com or call now.
At Sunset Subaru in Sarasota, it's all about getting more for your money. More years, more miles, more 2016 IIHS Top Safety Pick Plus winners than any other brand. Stop by to see our new state-of-the-art showroom today, and you can lease the most award-winning small SUV on the planet, a new 2016 Subaru Forester, for just $229 a month, complimentary maintenance included, at Sunset Subaru in Sarasota. Get more for your money. Go to Sunset Subaru in Sarasota.
Today, everyone is looking for carpeting that lasts longer. G. Freed has you covered with Karastan. With a legacy of quality and integrity, we provide you with a huge selection of Karastan carpets with exclusive lifetime limited warranties. All installed by our highly skilled, highly knowledgeable team. Come ask us why Karastan is the best and most durable. G. Freed Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.
U.S. Med has great news for anyone living with diabetes.
If you have Medicare, private insurance, or prescription drug coverage, U.S. Med will ship a new glucose meter right to your home.
And shipping is free.
My new meter uses only a speck of blood, so it's less painful than my previous meter.
If you have Medicare, private insurance, or prescription drug coverage, you're covered with U.S. Med. We're welcoming new patients, even if your current provider can't supply you anymore.
I don't even have to test on my fingers anymore. I can test on my hand or forearms, and it's more accurate than my old meter.
So call US Med today, and you'll have a choice of two great meters.
One that actually speaks your results, or a meter so small it fits on the bottle of strips.
Act now, and US Med will include a free prescription discount card. We'll also send you a free diabetes cookbook. This is your opportunity.
So call US Med today.
You'll be glad you did.
ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights. Now, the official Suncoast weather with ABC 7 meteorologist John Scalzi.
So looking at an air temperature that's already warm and steamy outside at 91 degrees, no reason to think that we can't add another 4 degrees onto that or so, getting us up to mid-90s once again. Dew point values at 72, east wind blows at 10. We got some cloud cover building along the coastline, and we've got some showers already starting in the inland areas. 88 in Wauchula, Arcadia, and Myakka. There's some scattered outflow from some thunderstorms that's moving closer and closer to those areas. 88 in Parrish, Bradenton, Lakewood Ranch. 86 degrees Longboat Key, 89 in Venison, 88 degrees in Inglewood. Yesterday, we had lots of thunder movers move across the state of Florida, rapidly exiting out into Gulf waters. Same thing again today. Scattered showers in and around the Atlanta airport, but nothing strong enough that's going to cause any airport delays there today, I don't believe. But along the coastline of the mid-Atlantic, areas like Raleigh-Durham or Charlotte, those airports, they could see a little bit of thunderstorm activity that could create some airport delays, not necessarily just along the coastline, but inland of North Carolina as well. Now, locally, we've got some showers that have crossed the state, and they're beginning to move into our neck of the woods. Some of them have produced some pretty good thunderstorm activity, one in Charlotte right now producing some lightning strikes and has a pretty good core cell there that's dropping some fairly decent rainfall, but rapidly moving so that the total amount of rain under one of these storms not going to be all that great, even though it may, you know, deluge for a minute or so. It's moving so rapidly that the total accumulation is not all that much. All of this will bring us today a kind of rainy afternoon at times. If you happen to be lucky enough to be under one of those storms, it'll certainly cool you off. But the total rainfall amounts, again, not all that great. High pressure to our north, directing our winds out of the east. Nothing changes there. The trough of low pressure located just to the north and sagging southward is helping to kind of tick up our wind speeds just a little bit today. So it will be kind of a breezy east wind that pushes that east coast sea breeze all the way over to our neck of the woods. It will not allow for our west coast sea breeze to build all that strong. In fact, it may eliminate it mostly altogether. So hot again today, scattered afternoon showers and thunderstorms, and partly sunny skies. Again, some of these scattered afternoon thunderstorms could produce frequent lightning, some gusty winds, and some brief periods of some fairly heavy rainfall. Watch the RPM computer model, put it into motion. The showers move on past this afternoon, and then tomorrow, guess what? Same sort of situation. They approach, and then they move out into Gulf waters where we're left with a fairly quiet evening and overnight sky. That'll probably be the pattern through Saturday, and then things will switch up just a little bit. The relative strength of the sea breeze depended on the relative strength of that easterly wind. We have the RPM computer model showing the amount of rainfall across the region, and there are some places where you're going to see a little bit more rainfall than others. The further south you go, the more likely you are to get better accumulations, but I don't think we'll top out much more than half an inch to an inch in most locations today that see the heavier rain. Now, across the tropics, things are pretty quiet. North of Hispaniola, we got a few thunderstorms in progress, and then part of the Lesser Antilles has some showers. St. Lucia looks like it's got a shower in progress right now, but nothing that's organized, nothing that's going to develop into any kind of issue for us over the next 5 days. Northeast wind at 10 to 15, switching to the east at 10 to 15, that brings us a moderate chop. And the forecast calls for chances of rain each and every day, and then perhaps a little less rainfall next week and slightly cooler temperatures with a stronger sea breeze. Donnie?
Thank you, John. In health news today, a major recall is in effect for P.F. Chang's frozen dinners. According to the U.S. Department of Agriculture, the product is being pulled off the shelves because of metal that may be embedded in the sauce. Dinners made between May 31st and June 22nd could be affected. Over 195,000 pounds of the frozen chicken and beef are being recalled, but it does not impact food served at the actual P.F. Chang's restaurants. The next time you pop open a cold one, you could have a better idea what's inside of it. Nutrition labels will be added to your favorite beer soon. The tabs will disclose calories, carbohydrates, alcohol content by volume, and portion size. It's a voluntary step that stemmed from criticism amongst consumer advocates. According to the Center for Science and Public Interest, alcohol can be a major source for calories, and the absence of calorie labeling on cans and bottles has helped obscure that. Now, Anheuser-Busch, Molson Coors, Constellation Brands and Heineken are all getting on board. Crown Royal and Smirnoff already added nutrition facts to bottles, while microbrews seem to have alcohol content readily available already. Beer won't have labels on their bottles until 2020. Now, the least favorite aspect of going back to school is probably those back-to-school shots. Abby Moore finds out how to avoid the headache of last-minute vaccinations in this edition of Cool for School.
With just weeks to go until school starts back, Amelia Andre brought her kids to a vaccination clinic at the local health department to beat the rush.
Well, I have three children, so I know from the first one, the earlier it is, the better it is. It's not that busy. So I want to beat that crowded people and just be nice and quiet.
Nursing program specialist Ann Waltz says getting it taken care of early is a good idea.
It tends to increase as we get into July, and right before school starts back, it is extremely busy. It is not too early to get those vaccines taken care of, and you can avoid long lines and frustration by getting it taken care of now.
Waltz says it's important to check with your healthcare provider now on your child's vaccination status.
The immunization requirements do vary from state to state, so if you moved here from another area, your child may have met the immunization requirements for that state, but it might be different from what Florida requires. So we urge folks to check into that early, not to wait until right before school starts back.
For mom Katie Etter, the process was quick and easy.
We had a great experience. The nurse was super sweet. She calmed Allison down and told her what a great job she did. And so we had a very good experience today.
One thing off her back to school checklist.
If you don't have a health care provider, check with the health department. Manatee County has already begun offering free back-to-school vaccinations for students. And still to come on your Suncoast News, the murder case of a Sarasota homeless man wraps up today. We'll have the latest on that trial, and also a USF football coach is inspiring kids in his hometown to go after their dreams. We'll have that story when we return.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
This is a special health alert for seniors suffering with joint pain. If you have Medicare insurance, you may qualify for high-quality support braces at little or no cost.
I'm thrilled with my knee braces.
Now, there is a simple and proven solution for seniors to get out of pain with state-of-the-art support braces.
I barely feel any pain at all.
Braces for your knees and back, as well as your shoulders and ankles, too.
I'm so happy with the quality of these braces.
Call now, and you could qualify for a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost.
I can play ball again, and it doesn't hurt.
And because of my Medicare coverage, it costs me next to nothing.
So call now.
And because I have this red, white, and blue Medicare card, my braces have cost me just about nothing.
It's true. You may get a knee, back, shoulder, and ankle brace at little or no cost.
They qualified me for two knee braces and a back brace.
If you have knee or back pain, give them a call. They can help.
1-800-476-8967. 1-800-476-8967.
They say good things come to those that wait. Well, you've waited long enough. You deserve to feel fabulous in your fashionable new Fiat 500X from Alfa Romeo Fiat in Sarasota. Boldly innovative, seductively stylish. Fiat gives you everything you'd expect from a capable utility vehicle, like a spacious interior and advanced safety systems, designed and built like a sexy little sportster. Don't wait any longer. You deserve to feel fabulous. Get a new Fiat at Alfa Romeo Fiat of Sarasota.
Is your old garage door stuck or broken? Would a new one give you a lift? Let Precision Door Overhead Garage Door Service of Sarasota come to the rescue with prompt and affordable repair service. Replacement doors come with an array of styles and colors, and they are rated to meet and exceed Florida standards. From estimates to installation, your satisfaction is our priority. If you're not 100% satisfied with any product, service, or installation, we will make it right, because Precision Door Service is a name you can trust.
Are you considering joint replacement or revision surgery? Consider this. Dr. Edward Stolarski has performed thousands of successful joint replacement procedures and trained surgeons from all over the world. Using advanced technologies, Dr. Stolarski is able to perform some of the most complex surgeries.
I wish I knew about Dr. Stolarski much sooner.
After the surgery, I don't have any pain. It's like I've got a 16-year-old hip.
My name's Ed Stolarski. What I really do is I give people back their life.
Schedule a consultation today.
Russia is getting no support from the World Anti-Doping Agency. WADA is recommending a total ban of Russian athletes for Rio for the Olympics. The International Olympic Committee is looking into the legalities of a total team ban, but is also considering cases on an individual basis. The charges from WADA came out of the 2014 Winter Sochi Games in Russia, with 20 summer sports also listed as being part of Russia's cheating conspiracy. A hearing Thursday in the Court of Arbitration for Sport that will be a barometer, the court is due to rule on Russia's appeal against the IAAF decision to ban its track and field athletes from Rio. A USF football coach is taking some time away from his boys to spend with ours here on the Sun Coast. The Willie Taggart DGA football camp kicked off today in Palmetto. Younger football players spent the morning learning the basic fundamentals of the game from Coach Taggart and his staff. It's open to kids between the grades of first and eighth, and giving back to the community is important for the fourth-year Bulls coach. Palmetto is Taggart's hometown. He played at Mantee High School, and the fields where the camp are held are right across the street from his childhood home.
Football has been everything for me. Everything you see in me is football, you know, and to be able to come back to give to the game of football in your community where you grew up, and for a lot of these kids to show them that you can, if you dream big, you work hard, you can accomplish a lot of things you want to get accomplished as well.
He also brought some of the USF players along with some of his staff, as we said. Also, Raymond Woody, who grew up in Palmetto as well. They've been lifelong friends, and he was also the former high school coach at Bayshore and Palmetto. Woody is now a key part of Taggart's USF staff. The day camp was free and wrapped up at noon. Now, let's get back to the kitchen where John joins our guest chef, Pedro Flores, from the Table Creekside Restaurant.
Indeed, always a pleasure having Pedro in the kitchen. Good to see you again, sir.
Thank you for having us here again.
It's always a pleasure. You cook up very interesting, tasty dishes that always have kind of your own little twist on them, which is wonderful.
Well, that's the little secret from the table.
There you go. Okay, we're going to share that secret
well,
with us today.
Today, we're going to have a nice seafood risotto. You know, start off, we have a nice array of veggies, onions, garlic, peppers, roasted peppers, oregano, and most important thing, too, that's the Florida lobster.
That's
they're in season
pretty,
right now.
Very pretty.
It is like a big mama.
I think I like Florida lobster better than Maine lobster. I think it's almost sweeter, I think.
It is a little bit sweeter.
Yeah,
than
I think
that.
So.
You know, first we're going to like squeeze some citrus in our water. It's already simmered.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Do you salt that water?
Very little.
Okay.
A little bit of sea salt.
Mm-hmm.
Just a little pinch and a half.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then you see the beautiful lobster.
It's gorgeous. Now, you have fixed that in a particular kind of way.
Yes.
It looks like you've split the back. And
I split the back. Mm-hmm. I'll open it, clean it up.
Okay.
Okay, and I have this wood skewer in the middle, so when you poach it, it doesn't curl the lobster.
Right.
Okay, so you go and you rub like that. Okay.
Now, a lot of people are nervous. Now, you're poaching. You're not boiling here.
No, it's not boiling. You have to cook it in a very little simmer water because mm-hmm. you don't want to overcook it. In other words, it becomes like rubbery.
Yeah, you don't want to do that. That'd be a shame.
Then another step, a little bit of olive oil.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And they have nice snapper.
Mm.
Like pieces of snapper.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, that looks
pieces
so
of snapper.
Fresh.
Fresh. Okay, a little bit more citrus.
Mm-hmm.
Just a little bit. Okay. We have a little bit more sea salt. Like a spoon of red peppers. A spoon of onions.
And you're using a sweet onion there, like a Vidalia or something
like
that?
You're right, there's a Vidalia onion right there.
Okay.
Yes, sir. And then we're gonna always drop. Tasty. Just be careful when you drop your stuff. Always a little in an angle so you don't burn yourself at home. Mm. And then you start sizzling.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. A little more oil. And then we got some hominy. White hominy is in season right now.
Which
organic.
Is corn, right?
Corn, yeah. But it's white.
Corn, yep. Yeah. White corn.
A little bit of that.
Mm-hmm.
And then you see we got these kiwi shrimp.
Beautiful.
34.
Look how
right.
Pretty those
citrus
are.
Citrus again.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you always want to put a lot of citrus. I like citrus in my seafood, so.
Got about a minute 30.
Okay. And we got this. Beautiful. Mm-hmm. We got some calamari, too.
Oh, nice.
Calamari.
Now, calamari curry. Squid cooks up pretty quickly, doesn't it? So
yes, it does.
That would be, I'm guessing that's why you added it last.
Yes, sir. Always. Always you add your calamari in the last minute.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mmm.
Then we have that. We have some snapper stock. So you can make it at home with the bones of the fish, tomatoes.
Okay.
Little tomato paste, little tomatoes.
Is that
tomatoes.
Pretty easy to make?
Oh, yeah, very easy. You just boil the bones, drop little tomato paste, little salt, little citrus. That's all you have to do now.
That's
and then
it.
We have the risotto here. It's already pre-cooked. It has onions, garlic, white wine, and a little bit of chicken stock.
Now, risotto is kind of neat. It's rice, right? Now,
it is a rice.
You normally don't think of an Italian food as rice,
yeah,
except risotto.
Exactly. We call it really risotto, tasty. But it's arborio rice from Italy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Kind of their comfort food.
Yes, sir.
Along with the pasta.
Mm-hmm, there you go.
And the wine. Italians have a lot of comfort food.
Yeah. Yeah,
but healthy. It's good stuff.
It is healthy, sir. There you go. A little oil in there. Cook beautifully. Okay. Then we have a little butter. You don't want to put a lot of butter. Just a little bit for flavor, so it keeps it creamy.
And
you
while
go.
You plate this up, we're going to remind everybody that the final recipe for this is on our website, mysuncoast.com. It's available for you to download, look at, and, of course, Chef Pedro's video instructions are there. And there's your final product. Doesn't that look beautiful? Looks like you've served it with some kind of special bread there as well.
Oh, focaccia. It's a homemade focaccia.
Nice. With looks like some sun-dried tomatoes on there.
Yes, sir.
Beautiful things. Chef Pedro, thank you so very much.
Thank you
for having
the
menu
at
the Table Creekside, right?
It's a summer menu, sir.
Oh, thank you. How beautiful is that? Out in the water there, it'd be great. We'll be right back.
They care. They take the time to understand you, take the time to understand your case.
There's no better satisfaction to me than to see a client who is happy because of the job we've done for them.
It's really actually very comforting to know that there's someone that you've heard of and you're getting recommendations about that you can turn to when you have a problem.
I felt like I had a partner in this and he was gonna be by my side.
Attention, this is an important message for anyone who had an IVC filter placed to prevent blood clots from traveling to their heart or lungs. Did your IVC filter move, break, or cause organ damage? The FDA warns that IVC filters may cause serious complications, such as heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, even death. If you or a loved one suffered serious complications, call IVC Filter Helpline now. You may be entitled to compensation. IVC filters are designed to prevent blood clots. If your IVC filter moved or broke, and you suffered heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, or if a loved one died as a result, call IVC Filter Helpline today. Our network of experienced attorneys is ready to fight for you. You'll pay nothing unless there's a recovery in your favor. Call today for a free confidential consultation. Don't fight this alone. Call IVC Filter Helpline now.
Please call 800-897-6764. That is 800-897-6764.
So many possibilities worth exploring. Manasota Flooring.
And for a limited time, Manasota Flooring is offering you unbelievable pricing on tile and laminate. Porcelain tile, only $1.59. Ceramic tile, 99 cents. And 16 by 16 tile, $1.19. Laminate flooring is only 99 cents. But these prices won't last. Don't miss out on these great deals. Hurry into Manasota Flooring today.
Dog days of summer got you down? Beat the heat with huge summer savings during the summer clearance event going on now at Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota. You'll feel cooler than ever when you drive away in a new Jeep Cherokee for as little as $19,999. Or take home a stylish new Jeep Renegade for just $18,599. How about a new 2016 Jeep Patriot for just $14,999? Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota.
Just because someone grows older, does that mean they have to grow apart from their friends or from the things they love to do? With Right at Home, it doesn't. Right at Home's professional team thoughtfully selects caregivers to help with personal care, housekeeping, meals, and most of all, staying engaged in life.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. Are you ready to go?
Oh, I sure am.
We can provide the right care right at home.
Live from our studios on Florida's Sun Coast, this is ABC 7 News at Noon. Your Sun Coast News. We're here for you.
Welcome back. I'm Don Brennan in for Scott Dennis today. And final arguments are heard this morning in the trial of a homeless man accused of murder 13 years ago. That man, John Melquist, is representing himself. ABC 7's Rebecca Vargas was in the courtroom this morning and joins us now with the details. Rebecca?
Yeah, Don Melquist made his final case of innocence to the jury in the murder of his former landlord and roommate, Annalise Schweikart. Before closing arguments began this morning, Judge Charles Roberts once again asked Melquist if he wanted to be represented by a public defender, as he did each day. And Melquist once again denied. He also refused to testify. In the four-day-long trial, the state brought in 22 witnesses, among them two former inmates who testified against Melquist, detailing how he murdered his landlord using a scissor and then knife to stab her to death. According to the inmates, Melquist was angry that she was evicting him.
I had no motive. I mean, I don't know what they think I needed money for and all that stuff, but she was trying to evict me, or she tried to. I said, oh, no, that's not going to happen. She changed the locks on me. I was there 9 days and she started all this.
Annalise Schweikart was killed by that man in 2003. Sonia Burrows knew it, Christopher knew it, Kathy Wingate knew it. And 13 years later, it's now time to hold him accountable for his actions.
The jury will now deliberate, and Melquist is accused of murder in the second degree. Don, back to you.
Thank you, Rebecca. As politicians are discussing how to make America safe again, the people of Baton Rouge are trying to come together.
A child's prayers at the memorial to slain officers capturing the poignancy of this moment in America, threatening to pit black against white, civilian against police. Here in Baton Rouge, people are nearly universal in saying they won't allow that to happen.
We want to keep the peace.
Alton Sterling's aunt tells me she visited this memorial because her nephew's death is not justification for the murder of police, and in a powerfully symbolic moment, she encountered the father of slain officer Montrell Jackson, and they embraced.
My heart goes out to Alton, his family, all the officers who was hurt, they family, and I miss my son.
Investigators are poring over the images caught on surveillance cameras of the shooter, 29-year-old Gavin Eugene Long, dressed in black, holding a rifle, waiting to ambush police at a car wash frequented by officers.
I'm hit. I'm on a car wash. I'm hit. Left arm.
Investigators now say he ignored civilians, targeting police, and taking the life of three officers who were remembered at a candlelight vigil: Brad Garofalo, Matthew Gerald, and Montrell Jackson. Corporal Nicholas Tullier remains in the ICU fighting for his life.
Police say Deputy Garofalo died a hero after running to help a wounded officer who was caught in the gunfire. He was a 24-year veteran. In Dallas, officers are paying their respects to one of their own. Officer Michael Kroll was one of five police officers murdered 2 weeks ago while working a protest. Kroll will be buried with full honors today. The 40-year-old Kroll is a Michigan native. Now for a good cop story, a rainbow amidst the rain. A video showing a police officer dancing with a group of Black Lives Matter activists at a community cookout, and it's going viral on social media. Officer Aaron Moses of the Wichita Police Department was busting his best moves with a cha-cha slide and the whip and the nay-nay at a barbecue this weekend. The 25-year-old says he always wanted to be a cop and never knew others didn't feel the exact same way. Although he never grew up in a minority community, he will try to serve them the best he can, even if it means showing his silly side.
I will never know what it's like to grow up and not trust a police officer. And I think once you realize that, it's a pretty profound thing. If I need to dance a little goofy and do the cha-cha slide to help people see that I'm a real person and that I do care and that I trust you, then that's what I'm going to do.
The 30-second video of Moses dancing has more than 3 million views on Facebook. And one of the country's hottest states is recovering from some much-needed rainfall, albeit very wet. A monsoon in Arizona brought heavy rains and high winds yesterday, along with flooded streets and knocked out power in many areas. It also caused flight delays. Many homes were flooded, too, and the water in the mud was strong enough to knock down a cinder block wall. Arizona's traditional monsoon season runs from mid-June to the end of September and is characterized by thunderstorms that stir up dust storms or rain. Now, more planets being discovered by NASA. An international team of researchers has discovered 104 new planets. Four of them could have Earth-like rocky surfaces, and the planets are between 20 and 50% larger than Earth by diameter. They've been added to the ongoing Kepler mission. The spacecraft was launched in 2009 to discover Earth-sized planets that may be orbiting other stars. The planets' discovery are the largest haul since the mission began. We're just adding on to the solar system, John. It's crazy.
Yeah, they keep finding these, planets in the Goldilocks zone. That's kind of exciting. You know, you never know. Not too hot, not too cold, just right. Maybe someday somebody will be able to fly out there.
And I bet
get
you
get a message out there.
That's right. But that dancing police officer, I bet he'll be popular on all the planets.
I think so. No, I think
good.
So.
That's good. Hopefully,
it's a beautiful thing.
Make people feel good.
Exactly right. We have some showers around that should make you feel pretty good, too. As those showers move on by, they're going to cool things off just a little bit. Lakewood Ranch webcam put into motion, starting off this morning with a rising sun and a beautiful blue sky. Now we've got some clouds building and some rain showers on the way to Lakewood Ranch. They're probably about an hour and a half, 2 hours out, but they're on the way. You can see them on radar beginning to build across the region. Some of them producing some pretty decent rainfall, and they span the entire width of the state. So this is not one shower and it's over. They're going to rapidly move across in, I guess you could call it, kind of waves throughout the afternoon. And that'll bring us that 50% chance of storms today. And despite those storms, the temperatures will still be warm, coming in around 95 degrees for a daytime high. Combination of that warm weather, the moist, humid air, should bring us a chance at some gusty winds with a few of these storms as well. We'll talk all about the forecast for today in the next few days in just a minute, Don.
Thank you, John. The family of a woman who died outside a North Florida hospital after being forcibly removed by police has filed a lawsuit. Loved ones of Barbara Dawson filed the federal lawsuit against the hospital and two of its former employees, the city, and a former police officer. Last December, Dawson died of a blood clot in her lungs after collapsing in the parking lot of a hospital in Blountstown while being handcuffed. The 57-year-old refused to leave the emergency room after complaining of shortness of breath. The lawsuit alleges four counts, including lack of emergency care, battery, and a civil rights claim. Following up now on a woman who tried to kill her children by driving her van into the ocean, as Ebony Wilkerson will learn her fate this Friday in court. In 2014, authorities say she drove into the Atlantic Ocean just off Daytona Beach with her three young children inside. Wilkerson stood trial for attempted murder but was found not guilty by reason of insanity. She was sent to a psychiatric hospital, and on Friday, Wilkerson will find out if a judge will send her back to that hospital. Back here on the Sun Coast, some residents in Manatee County could soon be living in a jail, but it's one that they can get out of anytime they want to. The county is asking for proposals to lease out the old jail building at the Judicial Center on Manatee Avenue, and they're looking to redevelop the space into housing. Yes, you're going to be living in jail. Ideas include apartments for condos for mixed income housing, especially for younger people moving into the county. Lower floors can be used for commercial space, and the deadline for proposals is September 15th. and South Florida Museum needs your pick to pick a birthday cake for its oldest and most famous resident. Three options are being considered for Snooty the Manatee's upcoming birthday party this weekend. The fruit cakes include all of Snooty's favorite treats like pineapples, strawberries, carrots, and cantaloupe. And to vote, just like your favorite cake on South Florida Museum's Facebook page. You'll automatically be entered to win one of three specialty Snooty portraits and a grand prize that includes an annual pass to the museum. Snooty's birthday is this Saturday. He'll be turning 68 years young. It's a community where kids rather spend their time outdoors than inside on video games. And we'll take a look at this week's A Place We Call Home. Also, speaking of games, we'll tell you about an event this week where you can learn about the local wildlife and still be a part of the Pokemon Go craze at the very same time. That's coming up next.
Mom needed more care than we could provide, so we called Granny Nannies. She now has around-the-clock caregivers, and we have peace of mind. Thanks to them, she's where she belongs, at home.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Hurricane season is here. Are you prepared? ABC7 has the information you need. Access our special Surviving a Hurricane Now. Learn how to prepare a readiness plan and survival kit. Know your evacuation route. Be prepared, Suncoast, when severe weather threatens. Access our special on our ABC7 app and all our live streaming platforms.
Apple TV, Amazon Fire TV, and Roku.
Batteries Plus bulbs keep stacks of batteries for cars, cell phones, watches, plus light bulbs for lamps, can lights, and appliances right on hand. Did I mention we also repair smartphones? Batteries Plus bulbs. Trust the plus. Visit Batteries Plus bulbs today.
Services.com. Until recently, getting older meant losing your energy, memory, sex drive, even gaining weight, but it doesn't have to.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jenny Wilkins, owner of Age Vital Pharmacy Research and Wellness. Reversing or slowing the effects of aging can be as simple as supplementing vitamins, minerals, and hormones that your body needs in order to look and feel young again. At Age Vital, we do this without taking harmful prescription drugs that often have a longer list of side effects than benefits. Growing older doesn't mean you have to feel older. Age well, Age Vital.
At Granny Nannies, we provide your loved ones with the care they deserve, compassionate and experienced help right where you need it most, at home. Visit us at grannynannies.com.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Sweltering hot outside. That's the tower cam looking out over the bay kind of belies the fact just how humid it is out there. Not a lot of cloud cover out in Gulf waters, but you look back west and certainly there are showers and thunderstorms on the horizon, and they will be moving into the area before you know it. We're looking at temperatures right now that have already cracked the 90 mark. We're at 91 degrees with a dew point value of 92. Now, you get a 90 degree plus temperature and you get a dew point in the 70s, you know that air conditioning is the only place to be. That's just the way it is. We have an east wind blowing at about 10. That east wind has been kind of persistent and it's going to keep blowing throughout the afternoon, 10 to 15. And that is going to really kind of push that sea breeze back toward the coast, not allowing that refreshing Gulf water air to move on shore and cool things down. So there you go. 91 Orlando, 90 Tampa, Naples at 90, 87 Fort Myers, 91 Jacksonville, Daytona at 90. Even in Tallahassee, you've got 91 degrees, 89 in Panama City, and locally, many places at or above the 90 mark. Bradenton at 90, Parrish at 90, Sarasota 91, 90 in Venice, almost 90 in Northport. Same thing in Arcadia, Wauchula, Mayaca City. You know, this is going to end up being one of the warmest months on record. Just like last month was the warmest on record, I think this month, too, will also be. It seems like every day we're running 4 to 6 degrees above normal. And don't see that pattern changing, at least until Sunday. Then there are some computer models that suggest maybe it will. We'll talk about that in a second. So a lot of thunderstorm activity popping up yesterday, a lot popping up now across the region, and some of those storms advancing in this direction.
with some pretty good lightning pops and some pretty decent rainfall totals. Locally, we've got to around Venice, up through Warm Mineral Springs, back into the state park. We've got some pretty heavy rainfall. Then around Wauchula, we've got some scattered showers in progress. And then down to the south, we've got some showers as well around the Arcadia region and some of those storms producing some moderate rainfall there. Down in Lee County, more storms in progress. You get the idea. This is the way it's going to be this afternoon, kind of one after another, racing on by, wave after wave. Total accumulation's not all that great because of that strong motion of air out of the east. High pressure, the dominant weather feature for us to our north. Now, the reason that I think we might change things up a little over the weekend is that that high to the north is bringing us that strong easterly wind. Well, some computer models suggest that that high may reorient itself a little further south so that our wind direction might switch coming in out of the west over the course of Monday and Tuesday of next week. If that happens, we're back into that flow regime that we had the week before last. You may recall that when we had morning showers near the coast, then everything moved inland and the temperatures moderated just a little bit because we got that flow of air off Gulf waters. We'll see if that actually plays out. Another very good model suggesting, yeah, it's not going to happen. It's going to stay exactly like it is right here. So we'll see how it evolves, and we'll adjust the forecasts appropriately. Like yesterday, hot around here, scattered showers, partly sunny skies. The showers come at us from the east, move rapidly out into the west. We clear out during the evening hours, and then tomorrow we do it all over again with more of those fast-moving showers. And perhaps a little better sea breeze, so tomorrow we might have some stronger storms around. Rainfall accumulation show pretty light for the most part. I don't think we're talking about any huge accumulations, even though we could get temporary deluges under some of these bigger storms moving past. But they'll be fast moving. Northeast at about 10 to 15 today, moderate chop. And the forecast calls for good chances of rain, lots of heat for the next several days, and then maybe a change next week. Don?
Thank you, John. The Florida Fish and Wildlife Commission will be holding several public workshops this week to get input on creating critical wildlife areas here on the Sun Coast. Tonight, a workshop will be held on modifying protections for the Myakka River after biologists proposed to create a year-round closure to protect nesting birds. Now, the meeting starts at 5:30 at the Northport Public Library. Two more workshops on designating Roberts Bay Islands and Dot-Dit Islands as critical wildlife areas will be held tomorrow and Thursday. Well, did you ever wish you could go back to the good old days out in the country with space between you and your neighbors, but still have all the benefits of modern technology? Well, ABC7's Linda Carson takes us to just such a place in our series, A Place We Call Home.
Hidden River is a gated community covering 1,000 acres. It borders the Myakka River and Myakka State Park.
When you pull into Hidden River, it's like pulling into your own sanctuary.
All the lots here are 5 acres, 5 to 10 acre lots. So people out here have horses, animals, you know, cows.
Hidden River has its own landing strip. Most of the 85 homes have access to the runway, and you can keep your plane in a hangar in your yard. Roads are also taxiways for the planes and riding trails for horses.
You might be driving down the street, meet an airplane. Horses are on the same street, people riding, or four-wheelers. And we all share the same streets. Of course, the airplanes have the right-of-way.
Stephen and his wife moved here 6 years ago. They wanted their kids to grow up in this country atmosphere.
They're not playing video games. They're not doing things much in the house. They want to be out, building a garden, riding their horses, riding the four-wheeler, fishing on the river.
And even if you don't live right on the river, there's a recreational area and a boat ramp open to everyone. And there's lots of wildlife.
There's every wild animal in Florida is in here. We got deer and turkey and I've seen a bobcat in here, and I never saw it. We had a panther go through one day.
Hidden River was established in 1968 by Frank Smith.
The place before it was an air park was a ranch, and the ranch is what had the runway. And last name was Smith, owned a ranch, and he wanted to build an air park out of it, and it's one of the first ones in Florida.
Residents know each other and have a strong bond.
This is a great place to call home, really, because we're a family of people who love aviation, horses,
the river, and just good old-fashioned country life.
Hidden River, it has all the peace and quiet of old Florida mixed in with cutting-edge aviation technology. A great place to call home. Linda Carson, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
Thank you, Linda. Bradenton's Robinson Preserve is getting in on the Pokemon Go action. This week, the preserve is hosting its first ever Poke Walk. County officials want to use the phone app's popularity and the preserve's popularity as well as an apparent Pokemon hotspot to show users how to play there responsibly. You'll also get a lesson on conservation and wildlife. It's a win-win situation, and more than 100 people are expected to attend at this point. The Poke Walk is this Friday night at 6:30. Speaking of Pokemon Go, playing the game will not count against your data allowance as long as you're a T-Mobile customer. The president of T-Mobile says the promotion was to thank customers with giveaways each week, and right now, nothing is hotter than Pokemon Go. The promotion is opt-in, and the exception lasts for a year. While this is a good news for customers, critics fear it will harm consumer choice over the long run. Now coming up, an animated Pixar film is finding itself in the record books, and Holy Matrimony is in the air for a British socialite. That's all coming up next in entertainment.
It's time again for My Suncoast's Bark in the Park with the Bradenton Marauders at McKechnie Field. Bring your best friend and let them run the bases in support of the Humane Society of Manatee County, July 24th at 1 p.m. Visit BradentonMarauders.com for info. Sponsored by ABC7.
Are you or a loved one currently suffering from chronic knee pain, arthritis, or osteoarthritis of the knee? Has physical therapy, surgery, steroid injections, ibuprofen, and other NSAIDs failed to provide relief? Then you may be a candidate for our Advanced Arthritis Relief Protocol. The AARP program utilizes the latest fluoroscopic guidance technology to deliver a new joint fluid supplement that cushions the knee and reduces pain. Specialized knee bracing is then applied to unload the knee and increase joint space. Finally, advanced rehabilitative therapies are performed to strengthen the muscles and ligaments of the knee. When combined, these treatments have helped many patients reduce or even eliminate their joint pain and return to normal active lifestyles. The best part is the AARP program is covered by most insurance, including Medicare. Tired of living with knee pain? Then call the number on your screen right now to see if you qualify for our Advanced Arthritis Relief Protocol.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names. Really? They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
Call right now to get your free Senior Care Compass ebook. Find out about the five best kept secrets on financing senior care and assisted living.
Call now, 800-290-0352. 800-290-0352.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere for the Sarasota Ford Promise. We promise we're more than a dealership. We're a destination with a movie theater, massage room, aquarium, cafe, and more. We promise to give you top dollar for your trade, even if you don't buy from us. And if you do, we promise you the best deal. Bring us any competitor's ad, and we'll beat it by at least $1,000. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301, sarasotaford.com.
Are you considering joint replacement or revision surgery? Consider this. Dr. Edward Stolarski has performed thousands of successful joint replacement procedures and trained surgeons from all over the world. Using advanced technologies, Dr. Stolarski is able to perform some of the most complex surgeries.
I wish I knew about Dr. Stolarski much sooner.
After the surgery, I don't have any pain. It's like I've got a 16-year-old hip.
My name's Ed Stolarski. What I really do is I give people back their life.
Schedule a consultation today.
Welcome back, everybody. Now, big upset for the Game of Thrones fans. The next season will be a lot shorter. That's according to HBO. Instead of the normal 10 episodes, there will only be 7, so fans are upset. It's not an upset for them. They're upset. Also, the series will start later in the summer rather than in April, which could take it out of the Emmy contention for next year. Over the weekend, Finding Dory set the record for the highest-grossing animated movie of all time in the U.S. One reason were the higher ticket prices. And according to the National Organization of Theater Owners, the average movie ticket has hit an all-time high of $8.73. That's up 1.4% from this time last year. One of the reasons for the hike? The surcharge for 3D and IMAX screenings. Yes, I paid $60 for 4 tickets for IMAX and 3D. It's wedding bells for Pippa Middleton. The Duchess of Cambridge's younger sister is engaged to hedge fund manager James Matthews. The 32-year-old played a prominent role in the 2011 royal wedding of her older sister Kate and Prince William. She stole a little bit of the limelight, she did, but the new couple plans to marry next year. And how would you like to own a lock of Marilyn Monroe's hair? Well, 2 blonde locks of the late actress's hair is going on the auction block in Los Angeles this fall. The hair is contained in a UV-protected case, and it's expected to sell for as much as $8,000. The locks are among a trove of Monroe memorabilia, which includes a sheer black beaded and sequined dress from the movie Some Like It Hot, and a large collection of photos of the actress at the 55 premiere of East of Eden. The items are from the estate of a fan who became a close friend. Wow. Norma Jean. Who would have thunk
it? You hear about that, locks of, you know, John Lennon's hair, Marilyn Monroe. I find that a little weird.
A little.
It's a little macabre, isn't it, really?
It is a little macabre. Now,
Even
autographs, like people signing their name for somebody. Just meeting or talking to them, I think, would be
That's
more...
not a body part, though. It's a little, I don't know. Maybe it's just me.
Could be.
Body parts. Anyway,
it could be a problem.
With that, have a good afternoon.
All right, more news coming up at 5 from the Republican National Convention.